Imagine if you could pick only stocks that would go up the most. Well, as far as I know, there's no sure way to do that with stocks, but there is a way to do that with bonds. This video will show you how, and it will show real examples of how this works, and how much you can potentially profit, and how it can even be better than the stock market. This video will also show the best way to combine investments in bonds with investments in stocks. There are five primary factors affecting bond prices: face value, coupon rate, market interest rates, accrued interest, and the credit rating of the issuer. This video will focus on the influence of interest rates and how to measure that influence. To understand duration, you must understand how bond prices are determined. The value of the bond equals the present value of coupon payments plus the present value of the par value, which is received when the bond matures. Present value depends on interest rates. Therefore, bond prices also depend on interest rates. The price of bonds move inversely to interest rates. When interest rates rise, bond prices decline, and vice versa. Learn more about bond prices and yields and about present value and future value in my video about this subject. The link is provided in the description below. Bondholders and portfolio managers are keenly interested in evaluating the risk with bonds. Since bond prices decline when interest rates rise, bondholders want to know how much bond prices will decline when interest rates rise by a given amount. The two primary methods of measuring interest rate risk include the full valuation approach and duration. The full valuation approach simply estimates bond prices when interest rates are increased in steps, based on the change in the present value of bond payments caused by the change in interest rates. In 1938, Frederick Macaulay devised a formula to simplify the calculation of interest rate sensitivity of bonds, called the duration. The interest rate sensitivity of zero coupon bonds is determined by their time to maturity. Zero coupon bonds pay interest only at maturity, equal to the difference between the face value and the discounted purchase price. However, bonds that pay coupons always have a shorter duration than a zero coupon bond with the same remaining term, so coupon bonds are less sensitive to changes in the interest rate than zero coupon bonds with the same maturity. Macaulay figured that a better formula for determining interest rate risk would incorporate the present value of the bond payments, since it is the present value of those payments that determine the bond price. Duration depends primarily on market interest rates and the amount and timing of cash flows. Duration measures the sensitivity of bond prices to interest rates. The longer the duration, the more a bond's price will change with interest rates. Duration has several simple properties. Duration is proportional to the maturity of the bond, since the principal repayment is the largest cash flow of the bond, and it is received at maturity. Duration is inversely related to the coupon rate, since there will be a larger difference between the present values for the earlier payments over the lesser value for the principal repayment. Duration decreases with increasing payment frequency, since half of the present value of the cash flows is received earlier than with less frequent payments, which is why coupon bonds always have a shorter duration than zeros with the same maturity. The simplest formulas for duration estimate prices better when the change in interest rates is small, and that the change will not affect the cash flow of the bond. Some securities have unknown cash flows, so their duration cannot be calculated exactly. Example: Treasury inflation-protected securities have cash flows based on the accrued principal, which depends on inflation. Duration can usually be estimated by comparing it with comparable securities with known cash flows. It is easier to determine whether the duration of one security is longer or shorter than another. Example: 30-year TIPS have a longer duration than 30-year Treasury bonds because most of the return from TIPS comes in the form of accrued principal, which is only received at maturity. This graph shows the greater interest rate sensitivity of long-term bonds over short-term bonds. The curve for the 10-year bond is steeper than the curve for the 3-year bond. Duration is the first derivative of the price-yield equation for bonds. Duration is the tangent line at the current bond price. Note that the prediction of the change of price with interest rate changes becomes less accurate the larger the change in interest rates. Graphically, the duration of a bond can be envisioned as a fulcrum placed under a seesaw so as to balance the weights of the present values of the coupon payments and the principal payment. This is the formula for the Macaulay duration. You do not need to memorize this formula, since this can easily be calculated using spreadsheets. I will show you how later. But do note that the formula depends on the present value of each cash payment discounted by the bond's yield to maturity. The bottom equation simply shows the Macaulay duration formula in sigma notation. Consider a 3-year bond with a par value of $100 and a coupon rate of 6%. and a current yield of 6%. The duration can be calculated as follows. Discount the cash flows by the market interest rate. Multiply each of those cash flows by the time period. Add the results, then divide by the product of the number of bond payments per year and the current bond price. For this example, the duration equals 2.79. The modified duration gives a better price estimate of the new bond price than the Macaulay duration formula. The modified duration is simply calculated by dividing the Macaulay duration by 1 plus the yield to maturity divided by the number of coupon payments per year. The modified duration can be interpreted as the approximate change in price for a 1% change in yield. So, if the yield increases by 1% and the duration of the bond is 3, then the bond price will decrease by 3%. If the yield decreases by 1%, then the bond price will increase by 3%. To calculate a new bond price with duration, take the negative of the yield change and multiply that with duration multiplied by the old bond price. Then add this bond price change to the old bond price to get the new bond price. Here are two examples. Example 1 shows a new price when the interest rate increases from 6% to 7%. Note that the yield term is subtracted because it is the negative of the yield change. In example 2, the market yield declines, so the yield term is added to the old bond price. Note also that in example 1, modified duration gives a price that is closer to the price based on cash flows than the Macaulay duration. In example 2, the Macaulay duration and modified duration give equally good approximations to the price based on cash flows. Excel and other spreadsheets also have formulas for calculating Macaulay duration and modified duration, as you can see here. This screen shows two examples of the Excel formulas. Freeze the screen if you want to study them in more detail. This graph shows that the bond price yield relationship is convex, so bond prices calculated with duration will become less accurate with larger yield changes. Note also that duration is not valid if the change in yield would cause a change in cash flows, such as making a callable bond more likely to be called. This graph shows that the modified duration is a slope of the tangent line to a particular market yield, and that the discrepancy between the price yield curve and a modified duration increases with greater changes in the interest rate. It can easily be seen that modified duration changes as the yield changes because it is obvious that the slope of the line changes with different yields. The gap between the modified duration and the convex price yield curve is the convexity adjustment, which, as can easily be seen, is greater on the upside than on the downside. Of course, there are formulas for calculating convexity, but most investors do not need to know this, so I will not elaborate any more on this, but I wanted to present it so that you are aware that price estimations can be improved by adding the convexity factor. So let's see how we can use duration for investments. Bonds with the longest durations have the greatest potential for capital gains. The key is to buy long-duration bonds when interest rates are at their peak. Because the Federal Reserve controls interest rates will only go so high because they have a negative effect on the economy. Usually, the Fed raises rates to control inflation, but once inflation is subdued, then the Fed lowers interest rates to try to prevent a recession. This is when bonds will increase in price, and long-duration bonds will increase the most. Since bond prices decline when interest rates increase, it will usually not make any sense to buy bonds when interest rates are expected to rise, unless you intend to hold the bonds until maturity, and never buy long-term bonds when the federal funds rate is near zero. Since interest rates can only go up, the federal funds rate is set by the Federal Reserve and influences all other domestic interest rates. Now I will show you how this works with a real example, comparing the Vanguard Long-Term Treasury ETF, symbol VGLT, with the Vanguard Extended Duration Treasury ETF, symbol EDV. The Extended Duration Treasury ETF consists of strip treasury bonds that have a long duration of about 24.2 years. The average duration for the long-term treasury ETF is 16.3 years. Both securities have long durations, but there is still a significant difference in their performance, so I will compare how they have performed in the past when interest rates have changed. First, I will compare three Vanguard ETFs based on U.S. Treasuries. Note that the three ETFs were affected similarly when interest rates changed from 2018 to 2022, but the ETF based on long-term Treasuries changed in price by a much larger percentage, even though interest rates changed by only 2%. Thus, long-term Treasuries have greater price risk, but they also have the potential for much greater capital gains because they have the longest duration. From the beginning of 2018 until the start of the COVID-19 pandemic in 2020, interest rates declined from the peak of 2.4% down to 0.5%. Note that the Vanguard Extended Treasury ETF increased 60% in only 2 years, while the long-term Treasury ETF increased 43%. Compare this with the S&P 500, which only increased 3% during the same time. Note that when stocks plunged, EDV soared. So a good investment strategy is to buy EDV when interest rates peak. Even if interest rates do not drop to zero, you will still earn good capital gains along with interest while holding the security. When interest rates look like they have bottomed, then sell EDV and buy stocks, since stocks do better in a low interest rate environment. If you think it is unlikely that the Fed funds rate will drop to near zero, below 0.25%, consider the fact that it has dropped below that rate three times since 2009. One important point to stress is that you should avoid credit risk. Bond prices will decline when credit risk increases, regardless of interest rates. Corporate bond issuers may run into financial problems when interest rates rise, which will reduce the potential for capital gains and may even lead to losses. Government bonds, like U.S. Treasuries, issued by modern governments who control their own money supply, have no credit risk, so they are the safest investment. Keep in mind that calculated prices from duration and even from present values are theoretical. Other factors also affect prices, though interest rates are the primary determinant. Thank you very much for your time. If you liked my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. I would appreciate any suggestions, so please leave them in the comments below. Check out my website at thismatter.com for more than 850 in-depth fundamental tutorials on personal finance, investments, and economics. Check out my books on money at williamspaulding.com. Thank you.